The second experiment in your syllabus is regarding chemical reactions. We know that there are different types of reactions. Chemical reactions can be classified using different criteria. Here we are going to study three chemical reactions such as exothermic, endothermic, reversible, irreversible, combination, displacement, etc. And we try to identify which type of reaction it is. In the first chemical reaction, we are going to take magnesium and burn in air. We take a small piece of magnesium metal. We need a pair of tongs, beaker, sandpaper, watch glass or china dish, glass rod, test tubes, test tube holder. We keep all this apparatus ready. We need magnesium ribbon for the first experiment. We are going to burn a small piece of this ribbon in air. We hold a small piece with a pair of tongs, burn it using burner or spirit lamp flame. We collect the ash in the watch glass or china dish. You will observe that magnesium burns brilliantly with a luminous flame and white ash is left behind. The flame is very bright. A very fast reaction takes place. Only one product is formed, ash collected in the watch glass. No gas is produced. There are two reactants, magnesium and oxygen, in the air. They combine to form magnesium oxide and heat is given out. There is a chemical change. Magnesium and oxygen combine to form magnesium oxide. So this is a combination type of reaction. Inference is that metals like magnesium react with oxygen to form oxide, which is a combination reaction. You can burn other metals also. Some processes are fast, giving a lot of energy. Some processes are slow. For example, iron, while rusting, reacts with oxygen. When moisture is around, iron oxide is formed. This is also a combination type of reaction. We have to be careful while handling magnesium ribbon because the flame is very bright and hot. You need to protect your eyes. In this reaction, two reactants combine to form one product, and that is why it is called combination reaction. Part 2. In this experiment, we are going to study another reaction. It is between dilute sulfuric acid and zinc. Dilute sulfuric acid, that is H2SO4, is taken in solution form. Zinc is used in powder or dust form. We take a hard test tube in a clamp of a stand, add some zinc dust to this test tube, add a few drops of dilute sulfuric acid. This is fitted to the test tube. You will find that the chemical reaction starts and some bubbles come off. Means product of this reaction is a gas. To confirm which gas is produced, we can hold a burning candle near the mouth of the delivery tube. There is a small blast with sound and gas starts burning with a blue flame. You will find that the gas has started burning with blue flame. This confirms that hydrogen is produced in this chemical reaction. Zinc is reacting with dilute sulfuric acid. Zinc is replacing hydrogen. That remains in the test tube is zinc sulfate and hydrogen is given out. So hydrogen is displaced by zinc. So this is a displacement type of chemical reaction in which one element of reactants is displaced by another element. Presence of hydrogen is verified by using the property of hydrogen, that is, hydrogen burns with a blue flame. Inference is that one element or a group of elements is displaced by another element or a group of elements, then the reaction is of displacement type. Zinc is more reactive than hydrogen, so it displaces hydrogen. Part 3. To heat lead nitrate. The third reaction we will observe is what happens when we heat lead nitrate powder. We will take a teaspoonful white colored lead nitrate powder in a test tube. We heat it on a burner or spirit lamp flame. Take care that equal heat is given from all sides. We will hold a moist blue litmus paper at the mouth of the test tube. We want to see the effect. We will also hold a burning matchstick or burning candle near the mouth of the test tube. What do you see? You will know that there is change in lead nitrate. A gas is getting released and blue litmus is turned red. The gas is also reddish brown in color. The burning matchstick or candle continues burning. It does not extinguish. In any reaction, when a gas is released, there are three possibilities. The gas itself starts burning, or candle extinguishes, or the flame continues to burn. Here the flame continues to burn, so there is no effect of gas on the flame. What conclusions can we draw? Lead nitrate, when heated, the gases coming out must be of two kinds: brownish gas, due to which blue litmus turned red, is nitrogen dioxide. The other gas due to which the flame continued to burn should be oxygen, because oxygen helps burning. We can see lead oxide in solid form is collected at the bottom of the test tube. We can see three products emerging from one substance, lead nitrate. They are lead oxide, nitrogen dioxide, and oxygen. When one reactant is decomposed, in many products, such chemical reaction is known as decomposition reaction. Here, lead nitrate was decomposed and three simple products were formed.